This is Lenny Farlee, Purdue University Extension Forester. Now let's ID that tree.
In this edition of ID That Tree, rather than just take a look at one species, we're going to talk about a very complex and diverse group of species across the state, and that's the oaks. From north to south across Indiana, we might run into 18 different species of oaks across the countryside. And so that can create some real challenges in terms of identification. However, one of the things we can do is divide the oaks into two broad but easily recognizable groups, and that is the red oaks and the white oaks. And on this sheet today, we've got the white oak group represented. White oaks have a tendency to have rounded lobes on the ends of the leaves and have acorns that mature in one growing season and have bark that tends to be a lighter ashy gray to medium brown in color. The red oaks, on the other hand, have a tendency to have bristle-tipped edges to the margins of the leaves on the lobes. Their acorns mature in two seasons, and in most cases, their bark is quite dark. And so from left to right, we have four of our species of white oaks that we can find across the state. On the left-hand side is our straight white oak, Corcus alba, one of our most common upland hardwood species. You can see the lobes almost look like fingers on the edges of this leaf. The leaves are quite variable, and so we have a lot of variation in terms of how many lobes, their orientation, and how deep the sinuses or divisions are between the lobes. But all the ends of those lobes are going to be nice and rounded. The acorns on white oak, once they mature, are a beautiful kind of chestnut brown color with a slightly lighter brown cap with rather knobby scales. Next in line is a species that you might actually confuse for a member of the red oak group. This is Chinka Pin Oak, another one of our upland oak that actually likes a higher pH soil, so we'll find it in limestone soil origin areas in many cases. This species looks like it has a sharp little tip at the end of the lobes. However, if we get a little closer, we can see that's not a bristle tip. That's actually a little gland at the end of the leaf. So it does not disqualify it for the red or the white oak group. It's still a member of that group. Light ashy gray bark bears its acorns in one season. You can see the acorns actually are quite small. Once they mature, very dark, almost black in color with a light gray cap. Next in line, we have Bur Oak. Bur Oak can be found on a wide variety of sites in Indiana, including prairies, as it's very fire resistant. One of the great identification characteristics for Bur Oak is this very deep sinus or division between the lobes about halfway down the leaf. We find that pretty typically across the species for Bur Oak, and also very wide, large lobes at the top of the leaf. Another great characteristic for Bur Oak are large acorns that are encased in this cap that covers a great deal of the acorn, sometimes not releasing the acorn very easily. And the edge of the cap oftentimes has these little hairs or burrs on the edge, thus the name of the tree. And finally, we have swamp chestnut oak. This is a oak of our southern third of the state found in swampy or wet areas, as the name implies. This would be quite a large tree. Very attractive leaf with small finger-like lobes all along the margin, and pretty typical for these leaves to be broader at the top than the bottom. And in fact, this species produces such a large and sweet acorn that the squirrels highly favor it, in fact so highly that I could not find an acorn to show you today, so the squirrels had beat me all to them. So you get an idea of the diversity of the white oaks across the state. We have about 8 species of white oak from north to south. So take a look at those leaves, see if you can find some acorns, check out the bark, and very importantly, bring a good field guide with you, and that can help you with identification of the white oak group.